Welcome to the Next Steps Launcher. In this video, we're going over how to build your launcher. We'll go over how to add actions, how to feature an action, and even how to customize the launcher so it feels at home with your church. Think of the Next Steps Launcher as the gateway to all of the most important next steps at your church. Things like sharing a prayer request, giving, signing up for a group, or planning a visit for someone joining your church for a service for the first time. The launcher is the perfect place for all of those kinds of actions and more, since it lives on every single page of your church's website as an easy-to-find home base for these things. This strategy effortlessly converts your site from simply presenting information about your church to inviting people to participate with your church, taking action together as they take their next step towards Jesus. In other words, the launcher was designed to make it easier than ever for your congregation and visitors to find the exact next step or action they need to take. No more hunting around your church's website to find a link or button you need to click. It's all right there in the launcher. To get started building your Next Steps launcher, head over to your Next Steps app, then Launcher. Here you'll be able to manage all of your actions in your launcher. So first, let's create a new action. Click Add New. You'll be prompted to create a name for your new action first. We'll enter Ask for Prayer, and you'll notice you'll then be prompted to select what you want that action to open when people click on it. And this is a good place to point out just how flexible launcher actions are to serve whatever need your church has. You can literally choose to open or link to anything on the web that's important to your church, open a next step in your launcher, or even create content that lives right in your launcher. You can also add as many actions as you want to your launcher. It's literally unlimited. Just keep in mind, only up to the first 6 actions will be shown on the main launcher screen, depending on their size. To walk through these options really quickly, Nucleus Prayer lets you open the free prayer hub for sharing and praying together with your church. A Nucleus Flow is great for signing up for things or asking a question right in the launcher. We'd like to say anything forms can do, flows can do better, and it all happens elegantly right there. Nucleus Giving lets people give tithes and offerings or other donations right in the launcher without being pushed away from your site, a behavior which leads to more completed gifts. You could also open info cards that you can easily create that open beautifully right in the launcher again, and also let you lead people right into next steps. And finally, as noted before, you can have your launcher actions open literally any other website or URL you'd like it to link to, whether that's a page on your own website, one of your church's social media pages, and even any other church tools you might use. It's incredibly flexible. For our example here, we're gonna choose Nucleus Prayer for what this action will open. This means our Ask for Prayer action will open the prayer hub for our church right in the launcher. This prayer hub is a really powerful solution for encouraging spiritual practice and is another completely free product we offer to churches for sharing prayers and praying for others who've shared prayers with your church, so be sure to check it out. Once we've chosen Nucleus Prayer, we just save this new action to our launcher, and that's it. With some types of actions, you'll notice you need to do a little more setup before the action becomes active. When you do, you'll see the row is dimmed and there will be a setup button that lets you know that you need to take further action. So for example, here's an action we added for signing up for a group, and we chose Nucleus Flows as the thing that we want to open. Well, to finish setting up this action, we'll just need to make sure the call to action that we'll display is right and choose the flow we want to link to. In this case, we'll choose our group signup flow from the dropdown. If you like, you can also feature any action right at the top of your launcher. And we cover featuring more in depth in another video, so be sure to check that out. The next step for you is to customize the text of the launcher. You can add an optional title if you like that's displayed under your logo, which you can upload under the Design tab along with customizing your launcher's colors. And you can edit and customize the discovery message here under Customize Text. This discovery message draws attention to your launcher when it's closed for those that are seeing the launcher for the first time so they know it's there and what it's used for. You can even customize the See More button text. This button displays if you have more actions than can display on the first page of your launcher, and this is specifically great for our non-English speakers, so your launcher can be customized to fit your exact language and style. If you have any questions on customizing the design of your launcher, what banners are, or how to install the launcher on your site, be sure to check out our videos on that, or reach out to us with any questions. Enjoy building your launcher.